Ok, sommet basse. I'm also a teacher in this class. I want you to pay attention. Eh? So yesterday I gave an assignment to the learners. And these learners have done work. The nurse is telling me, please, teachers, have you finished marking? We want to give some results to the learners. So I'll go and I open my Google Classroom as a teacher. So let me switch to be a teacher. So you should learn how to switch accounts. Are we there? Because you may be in this one when you want the other one. Then from here, I'll open the class. So when I open this class, are we there? I'll open that test. I'll go under classwork. And then I'll go to my subject, history. Under history, I'll see the test which was given. Now look here. For you as a learner, you are not seeing these figures. For you as a learner, all you could see was turning your work. See the worker do it and turn in, which we did before lunch. Are we there? But the teacher will always see how many have handed in, how many have been what? Graded. Are we there? So I'm going to click on this assigned. These ones who have turned in. There's Friday. So I can mark this one. I open his work. I don't know if the water is disrupting us or we are following. So that one is work the learner submitted. Are we there? Where is the red pen? Are you seeing up there where there is a pen? I touch that pen. Then down here, there is a pen which is showing colors. There is this one. So I may want this one, which is green. I may want this one. Let me use this red one so I can be able to mark. So I can just do this with my finger. I can get another green pen and I circle. Are we there? After that, I touch at the beginning here. So there are many places. There's even pain. I can even come here and I say, and I type something and I say maybe good work or something. You can be able to type. So there are many tools here that you can use. After that, at the top here, I can touch there and then I say save. Now my teachers there, they could even put there the mark. I'm going to show you. So after I've clicked on save, it is going to create another version of the work. There is this work which has been handed in, and it's going to create the marked script. This one was a Word document. The learner did the work in Microsoft Word and handed in. But after marking, it has become a what? PDF, and then it is marked. Then I can come here and I say, the learner's got 78. And I return. So that learner has been marked. And on a tablet, it's the bigger interface. I can even leave a comment. And I say, please do corrections. Okay. After I finished Friday, I just click on this arrow to go to another watch, another learner. I also mark this one. So all the learners, whatever they were submitting, you just move through. So this is what this one has handed in. Eh? If I was saying to scan in your papers, you are scanning other things. So I come here and I say this one, and I can say this one has got 20%. 20%. Hey. Up there, save. So there's no more requisition for red pens. There are very many on Google Classroom. Very many red pens. You cannot complete them. There are very many red pens on Google Classroom which you can use. So it is going to create a second version of the work where the learner handed in and then the mark script. And you see, we are two teachers who have marked. There's another teacher who is marking. Who is it? So he also opened and he ended up marking the same learner twice. So you see what he has marked? He has given the learner very good, and we have given 20%. So you should do. But of course, there in the normal classroom, each one will have his own subject. So no teacher will enter the other one. Are we there? So I'll be able to have that. Yes? No, I'm showing you how to do it. And I told you, you are here for 2 more weeks. So you are going to do this thing. You have created a demo class, isn't it? You created a class. Put there an assignment, send the link, let some of your colleagues come, then you test. Those are practice, will time for practice will be there. For me, I'm showing you how to do it. Are we there? So you are going to be here for more time. So all of you, by the time you finish the 2 weeks, you should have completed marking. So I'm just showing you the demo of what you're supposed to do. Is that okay? So basically, you can see now, I'm having my learners, all are having results. All the learners who have submitted work. You see, their results are there. And the other side, they can export these results into Excel, on the desktop version. And here, if I click on a learner, there is somewhere here where you can click on a learner. You see? Okay, cancel. You said, remember to return learner's work. So I can click on all these and I say return. So make sure that you return all these learners' work. Make sure that you return all the learners' work, those who have been graded. So if I go to people, a learner will be having a score sheet. If I go to people here and I click on a learner like this, they will show me all the learners' tests report card. Friday, he did this. All the tests will be here and the marks have been got. Let me show you something here. So when you click on any learner, it will show you that learner and the results. That the learner, how the learner has been performing in that particular subject. Are we there? There are even other ways. If we have very many, it will show us. Let me try to see here. If we have very many, it will show us these learners and each. Let me try to click on a learner here. Which learner here was active? Which name do I remember? If you click on any learner here, let me see. It will tell you that learner and the work. I think here I'm a teacher. So this is the other side. Because the learners will ask you, now how do I see my work? So members, please get used to this interface. Get used to the interface here and be able to see. So you see here, I see this learner. It tells you the overall grade and all the assignments the learner was doing ever since he started the e-learning program. So it tells you the overall average at the top. I think that this is another one. This is now mobile version. So you see all the assignments from various subjects and the overall average at the top. So you can be able to just know that this learner is active or not. And this can be exported also in Excel, and you can put it in your own report system and you still get the totals. Yeah, so members, I think basically when it comes to marking, I think those are the things that we wanted to tell you. There are some things that other settings and other things that you people need to know, but other things will come on board as we progress. Yeah, other things will come on board as we progress. And there is something known as settings. Let me just go to settings here a bit and I'll show you something. There are some settings that you need. When you click on settings, you bring back this demo class. Then from there, this one I said they are optional, you can put in. The class link is here. If you want to invite the learners, you find it under the settings. You copy this link, you send it in the WhatsApp group, the learners join. There is, if you are using video, if you are using Google Meet, you can put here the link so they can be joining via Google Meet if you are not using Zoom. Then there is this part, stream settings. I say in this part of stream settings, students can post and comment. Now, if you think there are some learners who are over-posting things in the stream, they are making it look like WhatsApp. They are posting other uncoordinated things. You can decide to change this stream so that learners can only comment on what teachers have posted. So you can say students can only comment. So in that case, the posts in the stream will be streamlined. So only what the teachers have communicated, then the learners can comment about it. Not learners also posting many other things and they confuse the class. So you can do that also, that can be for security purposes. So I can save that as well. Can you try to go and see if you can comment again in the stream? I've turned it off. You go to your Google Classroom and see. Go back to your Google Classroom and see whether you can post anything.